there is a massive move from politics of development, politics of money, politics of hate, to politics of rights. The people in Sabah and Sarawak must first understand what is it that they lost. And the most important thing, what they have lost, is actually their rights, their protection, and their safeguards, which is put in the Constitution but never implemented. It's not that particular about development issues, but they are very concerned about issues of their rights. And their rights, which is given in the IGC, which is given in the Malaysia Agreement, and put into the Constitution, which all the MPs swear to uphold and protect. We have to put leaders up there that look after us. Easy, Sabah and Sarawak, for their benefit. Kobol have already won in 1962. It will never succeed. It will break. The awakening of the people in Sabah and Sarawak is part and parcel of that warning. It goes back to 1969. Because on the 15th of May 1969, the federal government declared a state of emergency to the whole of Malaysia, even though riots happened in Kuala Lumpur. It has nothing to do with Sabah and Sarawak. And yet they declared a state of emergency covering the whole of Malaysia. Now, in a state of emergency, there is nothing that the federal government does which is unconstitutional. Okay? So meaning to say, during that time, if they come into Sabah and Sarawak and start pillaging and plundering our wealth, it's not unconstitutional. They can do that. The thing is that the state of emergency was lifted by our present Prime Minister on the 24th of November 2011. Now, once that one is lifted, all the law they created to pillage and plunder Sabah's wealth during the state of emergency now becomes void. That means that law cannot be applied to Sabah and Sarawak anymore. Suddenly people understand that they have rights. How come these rights is not given to them? How come these rights have been delayed for the last 52 years? So they are demanding for it now. Sarawak is taking the lead. What happened to Sabah?